Hi there, here Chef Bonus, and welcome to my channel, which is all about important terms for review. Well, I got some of four new terms where I want to explain and want to share with you, because we are the chef, so we need to know about the professional terms, right? So when we cook or we just deal with a chef, so we need to know about this few words that we just can't skip when we are really doing a really a great course, which is all about hotel management as a chef thing, right? So let's start without wasting time and let's understand what exactly it means. So before that, welcome to my channel, and don't forget to subscribe and hit the like button, and make sure you press the bell icon so you'll get the updates and what I'm just coming up with new videos with new terms, where I'm gonna add a lot of important things nowadays, because I got a lot of information about cooking and the sum of stuff like which you really need to know. So don't forget to press the bell icon so you can get the updates, right? So let's start with the terms that what I have. The first term is a failure. Well, a failure is a French culinary term to prepare a green beans for cooking by breaking off the ends with the finger as close as possible to the tip and removing the strings, right? And let me just explain you in a better way that when you have a French beans with you, or any of beans, you know that with the stem area, when you just see the bit on the top, you just have to click it and pull it down slowly, so there is a strings comes out, right? That is like not eatable, because that is not like if you boil it, cook it, whatever, it will be come out just like in a drumstick, you know, the residue, you have to throw it from your mouth. That exactly the strings comes out from the beans. You just have to hold the stem and slowly pull it down, so it will, the strings comes out, and when you just cook it, it'll be very soft and tender. So that moment when you have it, it's going to be completely chew, and no, you don't have to throw any of things because of that movement. The first step only, removing the strings, right? And that is the one, the basic thing to remove the strings from a string beans or a thin slice of almond, also called as effilia. But the pronunciation of the effilia is effili. Let me just tell you, and it's not effilia, is effili, right? Don't forget it. See, so quick and so easy to learn, right? It's just to need to know about the terms and where the terms are really going to work. Just use it and you're going to be a professional chef. That is all about, right? I will help you, no problem. So let's go to the another word. What we have is immense, right? So what exactly means immense? No problem, I'll help you out. To slice thinly, similar to julienne style, but not as long. So you know that it's not be a long when you're cutting the carrot, just to make it half and then make it a julienne. So that's not be a completely medium, so not gonna be too long, right? So immense is a French cooking term that means a slice thinly. It is often like English speakers to mean chop finely. So chop finely, you know, like chef used to say, like chop finely these things and all. So that means it means like get a julienne of carrot or any of things he's saying, of any of vegetable, right? He want to be. So at that moment, like when you go abroad or something, like learning about the cooking terms, so exactly that moment, if they ask you, that go and do the carrot immense. Immense carrot, and I need an immense carrot, right? But that means you need to know that it's about like this, trying to say it's like a chop finely, or they want to make a julienne. That moment you need to ask, actually, because means the both julienne and the chop finely. So chop finely is a bit different, I think. So according to me, chop finely is a different thing. Chop means something different way, it's not about the julienne exactly. But that moment we need to ask, because the size of the julienne is going to be the same, it remains same, right? For that reason it's called as immense. So you need to be know and quickly need to understand about the immense. So whenever somebody can say immense, you can easily understand it's a julienne, right? He's talking about, right? Let's go to another point that what I have is frenching, right? Frenching is a process of removing all fat. You understand that? The process of removing all fat, meat and cartilage from rib bones on a rack roasted by cutting between the bones with a sharp paring knife, often referring to lamb, beef or pork. Frenching is actually removing the fat from all, like we're taking a bone, right? We're having a rack of lamb, right? So in that, we just want to pull out the bones. So what exactly we require? A paring of good knife, which is really completely sharp enough that we can taking the flesh from the bone, right? That is all about actually is frenching. See, so easy and quick, right? Frenching, we don't even know about what exactly, but we always do the same work. But when we just see the frenching means removing all fat from the bone, that makes so easy, right? And remember, so anytime that I go to any butcher, so I can say like frenching the bone please, so I can take the all the flesh out from the bones and you can cook the bones well. I must say that cooking the bones is very delicious actually when you're making the brown stock. So don't forget to watch the brown stock and the white stock, the what I just made in a previous video, because it has all the basics. I must say go and watch. You can understand the whole concept of brown stock and white stock. I wrote the portions that how it's going to cook and how long it's going to cook. Do watch so you can understand better that what exactly this Frenching and where it comes. So use that word. Don't forget. Don't say that. Take the flesh out from the bones. Use the word Frenching, right? So advanced and looks professional. Sounds professional too, right? Let's go to another, the last, not the least. The word is harissa, right? A harissa is a spicy aromatic chili paste which made from variety of hot peppers and spices, often used by North Africa and Middle East cooking. Well, I must say that a North Africa and a Middle East dishes consist of ground meat and like a Bulgarian wheat served with the prepared with a chili sauce and other spices. Harissa actually is a chili paste with a lot of spices added to it for the flavor, and it depends on you that how you want to make it. But the main ingredient of harissa is the chili. The right proper chili and right color of like pitch red, right? That is called harissa. And well, let me say like what exactly and where you can use the harissa. Like in a burger mix, like mix the harissa paste in the burger meat and keep it for long and make the patties of it and cook it, right? Then you can go for the roasted vegetable, adding a little bit of that spiciness to the, because you're adding the harissa, which is a chili paste, right? And hummus, yogurt paste, chicken wings, you can make a harissa chicken wings, right? Depends on you that what chilliness you required, hotness, right? And let me tell you the recipe of it, and how really harissa is made. Like very simple, very quick, right? So it's like a carava seeds. You require a caraway, right? I think so. I'm good. Well, caraway seeds, coriander seeds, cumin seeds, garlic peeled, adding some of like 3 or 4 of that. Then kosa salt, then to taste, right? And then the extra virgin olive oil and some fresh lemon juice. Add it up and just quick blend it. That is all you ready, the harissa. Okay, so this is very quick and good to know about these terms about the harissa. And let me just add a little bit of my story. When I was in US, I was like cooking some of Indian dishes to for everyone. So when I just went is a Wyoming state, and it has like all like kind of different people coming from different countries. Okay, so I just prepared the chicken curry of Indian style. So it was really great for them to eat that, but a lot of American people, they like their out of that, because we are using a lot of chilies and all things, right? So they don't eat that much chili and they don't prefer that much, and they're not even familiar with all lot of spices. They most of like the things is a more important thing from them is salt and pepper, and the rest of the things that we used to add it, like thyme, oregano, something like different in all up for us is like completely international spices. For us is a coriander is all our basics for us when India, right? So when we I just added to my chicken, so our Indian chicken must be look red, completely red in color and spicy, and a little bit of more in spices when we add like coriander, cumin, garlic, then ginger. This also we add to make a very delicious sauce like curry chicken, right? So when I just made that one, so a lot of friends of mine, they are from actually South Africa, and they are from I think so mostly of my friends was who like the dishes is I can say Taiwan and Jamaica. So Jamaica actually the one of the people who love the food because they felt like their mom made it. So I can understand the culture, right? The food culture of them, that they equal to our Indian traditional. They even eat the same curry, but the taste of the, I can say like the my friends who are from Jamaica, they felt like they just got the home food. So I can say like also it's not gonna be so long story from my side. So this is what harissa all about, and it is all like a lot of people have it, and the making the same way is a chili paste, adding a lot of this spices according to you, and make a really a great harissa of yours own and make your own recipe. So this is for all for the day, and I'm definitely gonna bring more of new terms where you're really gonna feel good to learn about these things and quick and easy way. That is my main motto actually, to make you learn actually quick and easy way and feel like a professional chef, because everybody have their own hard work. So don't miss this all things, because this is also really a part of that to build yourself as a really a great chef. And yeah, this is all about like sharing is caring, right? So I do care for you for that, just care for me, and we'll like motivate each other and go for learning more and more terms, right? So thank you for watching my video, I must say, and see you in the next video, right? Thank you. Bye-bye.